This is cute.
It's cute.
Well, we could put a belt with it.
Jamaica Plain, making the world safe for small independent shops since forever.
You look so cute in that hat, actually. Like, for reals.
Hilken Mancini, owner of the popular vintage shop 40 South. She also runs the Girls Rock campaign out of her back room. And at night, she slaps on a Gibson SG and rocks her brains out in her band, the Monsieurs.
Do you like the hat? He likes the hat.
We figure Hilken and her fellow Monsieur, Andy California, might turn us on to some high-quality JP nook and cranny. First up, small plates at a little corner joint.
This is a fabulous restaurant called Tres Gatos. They have delicious tapas. You'd spend a long afternoon or evening in this joint, for sure.
Tres Gatos' innovative spin on Spanish classics has gained a loyal following. But if you can pull yourself away from the garlic prawns and bone marrow with roasted shallots, there's a surprise waiting for you out back.
You go use the restroom and you end up seeing, what's this over here?
Tucked away in a back room, a cool little record and bookstore, hints of which we now recall were hanging from the tree out front.
But that was the purpose, was to have this little space back here be something that you almost would stumble upon.
Given the restaurant's success, many folks assume the little store is a quirky afterthought. But that's getting it exactly backwards, says owner Dave Doyle.
The store actually has much deeper roots than JP than the restaurant does. The store goes back a long, long way. The restaurant was a way to sort of keep the store going.
Down the street, a straight-up record store. Deep Thoughts.
This is the record store Deep Thoughts. It's a new business in JP, but it's a rad business.
Deep Thoughts specializes in music for the adventurous ear, noise, psych, punk, and free jazz. Underground music, literally.
There's actually live music downstairs. Let's go check it out.
Deep Thoughts is at the center of a vibrant underground rock scene, touring bands that play outside the conventional club circuit. Tonight, Providence's Mini Beast is bringing the noise to the basement at Deep Thoughts.
You can go down there, see a great show, come up, buy a record, hang out. It's like a whole scene's going on versus just you're in a club and you have to stand there and buy a beer, you know? Oh God, this is a theme now.
Of course, the underground wasn't invented by urban hipsters.
There's an incredible amount of stone chambers or stone caves, stone openings in the Northeast. Most of them are aligned with celestial kinds of events, with stars and sun and moon.
The mysterious stone chamber in Upton, one of the largest and best preserved in New England.
It goes through for about 14 feet in a long tunnel. And then you go to the end of that and there is a spherical stone-shaped structure, much like a stone igloo.
The internet is wild with theories about the origins of this ancient beehive-shaped chamber. Vikings, Egyptians, even UFOs are mentioned. But Kathy Taylor of the Upton Historical Commission says the best evidence points to Native Americans. The orientation of the cave lines up with the summer solstice, as well as some stone features on nearby Pratt Hill.
These ceremonial stone landscapes are found all over the United States.
This ancient chamber is open to the public, tucked into a hidden corner of a park here in Upton, just a stone's throw from the 21st century.
It's right in a residential neighborhood, just in the corner of this property. And you have to know where it is or you'll be wandering around the 7 acres. It is totally amazing. Very important.
And the chamber is actually really quite large, going up about 10 feet to the top of the dome. And they did some research a few years back, and they believe it was built sometime between 1350 and 1625 AD.
Right, listed on the National Register of Historic Places as well for its cultural and religious significance for three tribes, the Narragansetts and the Mashpee and the Gayhead Wampanoags. So it's a very important place culturally and religiously. One quick thing, back to the Monsieurs, they have a new album out, and our producer, who knows his stuff, says it slays.
Oh, all right there. Mm-hmm. Okay, in Cambridge, a site to make a scientist sigh.